You have heard the gospel again and again and again. You have heard, as with the ark, there is one door. One door. You've argued with it in your mind, thinking, surely one person cannot die for the sins of the world. Well, that's your plan. And since you're not in charge, I'd rather believe the one who is. And he says, he who knew no sin was made sin for us, that we might be made the righteousness of God through him. There is one God and one mediator between God and men, the man Christ Jesus. I am the way, the truth, the life. No one comes to the Father but through me. One door. And we read, as they've come into the ark, verse 16 ends, God closed the door behind them. Never to be opened again until the floods are abated. He does not want anyone to be destroyed. So before you paint God as dreadfully cruel, remember they were given 120 years. You're given a lifetime. You hear the truth. The gospel is offered. The cross is raised up. You're told that there is one way to reach God and know him and be in his heaven forever. And you continue to resist it. It's your call. My privilege as a minister of the gospel is to assure you that God tells the truth, that there is hope, that the door is still open. There is one door. You may come into that door by faith in Jesus Christ, and in coming in, you will be rescued from this kind of future. You may choose not to, which means you will not be rescued. And you will answer to the God who made you, who did not want you to perish. But you made that call. You may be the one convert that needed to hear this today. And today is your day to trust in Christ.